The year 1777.
Goo! Goo yourself, yeah. You little dribbler.
The place? The American colonies. The battles between the colonists and King George of England had reached the boiling point. For the Founding Fathers, it was time to make a clean break from England.
Hey, guys, you gotta see this. Bobby, that walk again.
Hey, Benny, baby, good work. I'd have done it myself, only I had a dental appointment with my carpenter. We should talk about your promotion.
Look on the bright side, Super. After I defeat you and take over as Alpha Lion, you'll have so much more time to spend with your pathetic excuse of a son.
Hey, you're right. You all deserve promotions.
I'm better looking, I have better hair, I'm deceivingly smart, and I want everyone else to do what I say.
Oh, yeah, Benny. Pretty spiffy, huh? And they got my good side, too. And just think, in about 200 years, this thing will be worth almost 23 cents. Pretty wild stuff, huh? Hey, I'm starved. Continental breakfast on me.
Okay, yeah!
The prodigal son returns. This is perfect!
I thought you hated Super.
No, I do. I do. I do. I hate him. Oh, I do. And I'm going to use Alligator, yes. I'm going to use him to get rid of Super once and for all.
You must stay here to lead them when they arrive. We have no choice. It's the only way, Father.
I wish, my dear, you weren't right.
I thought you said sanitize!
Well, I don't eat anything with a head on it.
Well, what about sterilized?
Well, I'm a vegetarian, Bobby.
Well, make up your mind! Do you want it sterilized or sanitized?
Bobby, did you know that the average person consumes 500 chickens? That's enough chickens to feed a whole starving village. But they shouldn't eat them.
Better!
The cavalry was led by General George. Native American Indians called him Yellow Hair.
I call him Stares in a Mirror.
But what if we can't see the whites of their eyes? Or what if they're wearing sunglasses?
Yeah, dude, it's bright out. If they were smart, they'd be wearing sunglasses.
Dominique Jean Luray, chief surgeon to Napoleon's army, invented the first ambulance, followed quickly by the first ambulance siren.
Zoom Racer Extreme 3? You mean that new racing video game with the crazy stunts?
Prepare to zoom or meet your doom.
It's my favorite game. Mine too. Man, I've got Zoom Racer Extreme 1 and 2, but I don't have 3. It's been totally sold out around here.
I'll bring it for you tomorrow.
All right.
On 1777, Sybil Ludington brought the horse to go look for trouble. Especially with Ludington to look for trouble at the destruction of Danbury Zone.
I'm coming, I'm coming.
Sybil, what are you doing out?
No time, Edmund. Danbury's under attack. Ride east and tell Robert, Israel, and Paul to be at the colonel's by dawn.
Will do, Sybil.
Yeah!
Oh my gosh! Straight ahead! You won't believe it!
Whoa, Zebra!
Whoa! Oh my gosh! What a crowd! This was the home of the President of the United States!
Frankly, he's been a pain in my derriere for years.
They will never destroy the spirit which I have witnessed in the likes of Colonel Ludington and his daughter.
La Fidèle! It's gone! The bell has been stolen!
We must find her or the festival will be ruined!
Sarouche! How could I have been such a fool?
Seal off the city, every street, every river, every alley. They won't get far with a bell that size.
Of course. Now how about the lampshade? Can we give that up too? You know, the one in your quarters? Fancy one with little whales on it?
Oh no, that's my favorite.
So don't give up the lampshade?
No, or the ship.
Right.
And so, after Benedict Arnold finds out what happened to Danbury, it was Sybil and Mr. Lon Kiddington found the fire spread on the destruction of Danbury Zone.